Hey guys, Dr. Bobby here. Listen, I had a few minutes while I was on call and I wanted this to be super informal because I wanted to just take a moment to connect with you more on a personal level. I didn't want it to be sort of stuffy or super informational because I wanted to talk briefly about an experience that happened to me as of late. I'm sure you've seen the title of this video, so you clearly know what this video will be about. I recently started a YouTube channel. You're probably either watching this on YouTube or on Facebook or some other social media platform. So you already know that. And hopefully you are subscribed and you've liked the videos and all of that other stuff, which I won't even ask you to do in this video. But after publishing my first video, well, even prior to publishing my first video, I was pretty nervous about putting myself out there in the public. You know, many people that are my social media friends obviously know that I'm an outgoing person, but I'm typically pretty private. I love connecting with people on a personal level, but I never have been much in the way of a public figure or even somebody who would otherwise put themselves out in the front. And I think for a long time I thought about doing a YouTube channel because I think that some of the stuff that I know and some of the experiences that I've been through are things that I think other people would resonate with or find value in. But, you know, we all have that insecurity and that fear that goes along with putting yourself out in the front and being judged, you know, by whomever. And so I allowed that to cloud my thoughts of even starting a YouTube channel or even doing anything for a long time in this pandemic, and just the recent loss of loved ones, etc., has really lit a fire under me to live now and to do everything that you think you need to do to fulfill your purpose now, because tomorrow is not promised. And so, getting off my soapbox, I just wanted to share with you that I was recently on TV for the first time ever in my life. And that was a really interesting experience and a really awesome experience, and it just sort of falls in line with following your passion and doing what it is that you feel is you're being led to do, and how that can sort of make room for you at the end. So I'd just like to encourage you all to, if something's fervently in your heart and you have fear holding you back, do it scared. Now, with that being said, that I recently posted my first YouTube video probably about a week and a half ago, and to my surprise, that was pretty well received, and that resulted in me getting a phone call and being asked to be on CBS in Baltimore. And many of you know I reside there, but I thought that was really interesting that, you know, in line with me pushing past the fear of actually putting myself out front, that I was invited and given an opportunity. So shout out to Vic Carter and shout out to the folks over at CBS and WJZ in Baltimore. I had a phenomenal experience and I'm forever grateful and thankful that you asked me to even be a part of your platform. So thank you very much. So we did the interview and to my surprise, it actually came on TV. And it didn't just come on TV one time, it came on TV like three or four times. So thankfully I had already done a YouTube video and had gotten over all of the insecurity and the cringiness of seeing yourself and seeing how you look on TV and what your face looks like and all of that stuff. So that didn't really bother me, but you know, it was really just the opportunity and the idea that when you are following what it is that you're being led to do, how things just sort of happen in divine order. So I'd really like to encourage you all to follow what it is that is inside of you and what you believe you are being led to do. And without further ado, this is my first television interview. Please do not judge me super harshly. Obviously there's some room for improvement there, but I am committed to coming to you weekly. And I'm also committed to continuing to improve my ability to be out in the front. So here's my TV interview, and I'll catch you on the next video. Peace.
Well, throughout this pandemic, we have seen the weary faces of those who are on the front lines, the healthcare professionals who are risking their own lives to save others.
The true heroes. Well, Vic joins us now with a conversation with one physician who is there engaged in the battle. Vic.
Well, Rick and Denise, we can only imagine what it's like for doctors, nurses, technicians, and other folks who work in hospitals, who are right there on the front lines working to save lives as winning this battle against the coronavirus. Today, I talk with a Baltimore-based anesthesiologist. Dr. Bobby Burgess says that the methods for treating COVID-19 are changing rapidly, and doctors are doing all they can to simply keep up.
As you know, there are constant changes that are coming out in terms of what we are understanding as it relates to how this virus operates, what we call the pathophysiology of the virus, how it attacks people's bodies. We're constantly being inundated with new information, which then causes hospitals and governing bodies to put out new guidelines. So there's always this hypervigilance to ensure that you're actually treating patients with the most up-to-date evidence-based information.
How are you getting this information?
So most of the information that we're getting in terms of evidence-based ways in which we treat patients comes directly from governing bodies of organizations, primarily because a lot of these patients are critical care patients. Our critical care colleagues are getting this information from the small trials that are coming out.
Describe for me in the most human of terms the scene that you are faced with and other physicians are faced with every day when you go to work. What is it like?
There's just a hyper concern about protecting yourself at all times, which is palpable from the folks who clean the room down to every nurse and every physician you come in contact with. So people are just scared.
Well, just this past weekend, we saw that a New York who herself is a survivor of COVID-19 committed suicide near her parents' home in Charlottesville, Virginia. And while that may be the extreme, it does demonstrate how emotionally draining it is for everyone who is involved in healthcare right now. By the way, Dr. Bobby Burgess has a YouTube to answer questions about this pandemic. We have a link posted on our website at wjz.com.